In this video, we'll discuss trial preparation considerations in Experiment Builder. You might have noticed that the basic trial events, like the presentation of the images to the participant, are not directly inside the trial sequence. Instead, they are placed inside of a sequence that has been labeled recording. This is because we need to do a little bit of trial preparation before we actually start recording eye movement data and executing the important trial events. So, on each iteration of the trial sequence, we typically want to do a few things to get ready for the trial. First, we use a prepare sequence action to load any experimental stimuli that will be presented to the participant into the display PC's memory buffers. This way, when it is time to actually present the stimuli, the computer already has the files associated with these stimuli loaded in its memory. In this project, the stimuli only consist of image files, but the prepare sequence action will also pre-buffer video and audio files if a project uses them. And the prepare sequence action also allows us to transfer a display screen action's contents to the host PC so that the experimenter can monitor where the participant is looking in relation to experimental stimuli during the trials of the experiment. To do so, we need to do two things. First, we make sure that the prepare sequence action has its draw to iLink host property set to image. Second, we need to then select one display screen action in the recording sequence and check its use for host display property. We should make sure that all other display screen actions have their use for host display property unchecked, as the host PC can only display one static image during the trial. Once it has started recording data, it cannot update its backdrop. Note, this limitation does not apply to visualizing the data in Data Viewer after data has been collected. Note, you can also send commands to the host PC to draw simple shapes to represent the locations of stimuli in your experimental trials. Though the Posner task does not illustrate how to send these drawing commands, the Pursuit example, which can be accessed through the File Examples menu, illustrates how to send these types of drawing commands. Next, the Drift Correct action will present a single fixation target on the display PC monitor. The position of that target is determined by the X location and Y location properties of the Drift Correct action. During the experimental session, when the project gets to this Drift Correct action on each trial, the experimenter can compare the gaze cursor position to the actual target position on the host PC. When the participant's gaze is steady on the fixation target, either the experimenter or the participant may press the spacebar on the keyboard to start the trial. Note, the Drift Correct action is optional, but often it's a good idea to include this in your project. Besides helping to ensure that the participant's gaze is at a certain location when the trial begins, they also give the experimenter an opportunity to evaluate the accuracy of the calibration model. Moreover, if the experimenter decides the system should be recalibrated, then instead of pressing spacebar to begin the trial, the escape key can be pressed to put the display PC and host PC back into camera setup mode so that you can recalibrate and revalidate. Once recalibration is complete, the experimenter can press O or click Output Record, and the project will pick up where it left off. Once the Drift Correct action's fixation has been accepted with the key press, the project will enter the recording sequence. The recording sequence of the project should always have an iteration count of 1. This means that the recording sequence is not used to do any looping. It is the trial sequence that handles the looping through the various trials of the experiment. And the recording sequence is really mostly being used to control eye tracker recording. Because the recording sequence's iteration count is 1, There will just be one iteration of the recording sequence for each iteration of the trial sequence. And because the recording sequence's record property is checked, the project will send a command to tell the iTracker to start recording iData when experimental flow enters this sequence. And it will send another command to tell the iTracker to stop recording iData when the experimental flow exits the sequence at the end of the trial. Additionally, when the experiment exits the recording sequence, it will also send a set of special messages behind the scenes to log the values of any data source columns and variable nodes in the project. This will allow those variables to be accessible in DataViewer, including in any of the output reports that can be created. Please see the video on data output reports in the DataViewer video tutorial series for more information on this. Next, it's a good idea to check the isRealTime property of the recording sequence. This elevates the priority of the Experiment Builder application and helps to ensure optimal timing of experimental events. Finally, Experiment Builder has the ability to send a message to the experimenter for each trial of the project. The iLink record status message property of the recording sequence is responsible for sending this message to the experimenter. In this project, our message gives feedback telling the experimenter the current trial number and how many trials are in the project in total. To see and edit this message, simply click on the iLink record status message property. This message uses string concatenation and references to the iteration and iteration count properties of the trial sequence to create a string that tells the experimenter what the current trial number is out of the total number of trials to do. For a reminder of these best practices in Experiment Builder programming, remember to check out the Experiment Builder project checklist that is part of the user manual. You can access the checklist by going to Help, Contents. This checklist serves as a reminder for how to do things like trial preparation, and it can help you to avoid headaches in data collection and data analysis.